This video, I want to go over some differences between a loft and a boundary surface. Here we can see as we try to make a loft between these two sketches that intersect each other, it's not possible because the profiles are not allowed to loft into each other. Boundary surfaces, however, can be made using two sketches like this by simply changing the directions that these sketches are defining. Here we can see we've made a boundary surface as well as the curvature combs that are making this surface possible. Curvature is one of the main differentiators between a loft and a boundary surface, which we'll see in a moment. On to a more complex example. Let's look at a typical scenario where we could use a loft or a boundary surface. The tool that we need to use is defined by the type of design intent and constraints we need to have on this design. We have two splines lofted in one direction, two in the other. In this case, we created it with a loft. Take a look at our lofted surface. Turning off curvature display is handy to be able to understand the curvature of our surface before we create it. You can see different start and end constraints. This ends with tangency rather than curvature. While one set of curves creates our loft, the other set provides guidance. This is not the same as a second direction as we have in a boundary surface. Hitting OK to this loft, let's see how we would do this with a boundary. Navigating to our command, we'll select direction 1 and the curves that define direction 2. I may have misclicked here. Now I can't get guidance to make the curve I want. Quick tip if you've never known, if you click closest to the vertex that you want to connect in the loft, it will actually make sure that that alignment occurs on your selections automatically. We'll select these curves for our direction 2. Find our boundary surface. A primary difference between a loft and a boundary surface is this drop-down right here. We can do curvature to face and conditions. This maintains curvature continuity in both directions to ensure smooth transitions between all of the different types of faces that may be abutting to this boundary surface. Once those conditions are set, we can hit OK. To get verified proof that the curvature is different, we can actually use some of the evaluation tools inside of SOLIDWORKS. Hiding our sketches and moving our lofted body, we can then go to Evaluate and select Curvature. Not only can we see what the curvature is, but there is clear graphical representation that the curvature is different, even though the surfaces may look the same inside of the software based on our document properties. This has been a brief overview of the differences between a curvature and a loft command.